Hello, thank you for watching Urban TV, People and Profiles. I am your host, Jackie Achan. My guest tonight on the show is the one and only Patience Museveni Rabogo. She is a farmer. She is an industrialist. She is a mother. She is a sister. She is a priest, as well as a book author. We are going to talk a little bit of everything I have mentioned as we try to get to know who Patience Museveni Rabogo is, and also get to know her walk into the journey of pastorship. But before we get to, you know, talk about that, we shall also look at her journey into, you know, authoring a book. Patience has a new book that she has authored that will be coming into the market very soon. So we'll get to know what inspired her to write that book and what purpose it intends to serve. But before we get there, let's get to know a little bit about Patience. So welcome to the show, Patience. Let's start by you telling us about who is Patience. Get to know about your childhood. What was it like, family, growing up in the first family, and your journey into pastorship?
Well, I'm a wife. I'm a wife. I've been married to my husband now for 21 years this year, and we have four children. 21 years. This July it will be 21 years. Yeah. So we have four children, and I'm a servant of God. I'm a minister of the gospel. I'm a businesswoman. Farmer, entrepreneur, so a number of different hats.
I just want to know a little bit about you growing up, your relationship with your family and your siblings. What kind of child were you growing up?
Well, we had two sides, I think. We had an unconventional childhood in terms of our experience, our parents, calling in life took them in a different direction than maybe other families. So we lived in exile. I was born in exile. Many of my siblings were born, three of us children were born in exile in Tanzania. And we lived in different countries because of the situation in Uganda that time until around the age of seven. So at around when I was seven, that's when we returned back home to Uganda. And so in that way, there was a lot of moving around and not being together as a family, like other families, maybe. So that it affected us in that way. But in other ways, we were just a very normal family, very nothing different, really. Just our parents were present when they were with us. They were always very present parents. They were not distracted or... It's now when I'm older that I realize that they really made a priority to be present when they were at home. They were even if they were busy, you would never feel that they are not focused on you or something like that. So in that way, it was a normal life. Yeah, our parents were, I think, they were intentional about how they wanted to raise us. About they wanted us to be, grounded. And also to know that we make our own way in life. So there was never any, external sort of, perception or projecting something. It was always about, developing your character, doing well in school, being a productive person. So that in that way, it was very, very ordinary, normal. I think it's outside, maybe people have a perception that there's something different, but they were intentional that we should be grounded, ordinary, normal people who know who they are. Their identity is based on not these externalities. As a child, I think your the way you see things is different than an adult. I'm sure if I was older, I would be seeing, more. But as a child, you're focused on, school, So we came to school and the school was very different. We went to Kampala parents. The school system was very different from the way it was in Sweden, where we had come from, which was very relaxed and very, you know, just children play all day and all that. So when we came to Uganda, we came to Kampala parents, it was very, you know, tough and academics and all that. So you, as a child, you're focused really on your small world. You don't really, you're focused on now sort of surviving P2 or P3 or whatever class you're in. So I think that was my world really when we came back. You'd also recognize that, you know, the country has come out of war. You'd see those sort of images, you know, things on the news, and you'd see that there's the country has come out of this hardship, but your immediate world is just really school and surviving, surviving whatever class you're in. The adjustment, I think, for me, at least I can speak for myself, because I think I was also quite young, was adjusting to the academic system, which was a bit different. So that was where I had a bit of struggle. But, you know, children make friends, you quickly make friends, you quickly integrate, you know. So I didn't have any struggle with that. But the struggle was more like, oh, the homework is so much, or they don't allow us to play, or you can never do, you know, that kind of thing. But not that you struggled with the you know, other things, yeah.
Before I came here, I was trying to read around about you. And what's interesting thing I got to discover is that you are the favorite child of your father.
Oh, there was never anything like this is the favorite or this is that was not the dynamic at all. I think my parents, again, they were great parents, and they gave every child first of all acceptance and freedom to be who they are and to follow the path that God has for them. So there was never any sort of this is the one the favorite or no. We were also very close, as I share that in the book. We're also very close as siblings. That was something I think that my mother really wanted us to be close. She really instilled that in us, that we needed to be friends, that we needed to support each other from a young age. And that has been a huge blessing in our lives now, because my first friends really were my siblings.
At the beginning, I mentioned how you are so many things, from being a farmer to an industrialist to a priest to a mother. These are so many responsibilities in one person's hand. How do you manage to juggle all this and create a balance so that you can have the best of all worlds?
For me, my family is a priority. My relationship with God, as a Christian, first of all, even before the ministry, and then my family, the priority, then the work of the ministry, then business and other things. So I think it's you are busy all the time, but I think priorities. What is your priority? If there's ever a conflict, if it has to be this or this, then you have a priority and say, this comes first, this is more important. Yeah, but also my husband and I have always worked together. We've always worked our business together. And so that helps you're sort of pushing in the same direction. It helps a bit with the work and being entrepreneurs, being business people, you kind of set your own schedule. You're able to manage your time differently than if you were, you know, in a 9-to-5 where you have to just show up at a certain time. So you juggle different things, but I think also having priorities and also starting young, I think, is also a good thing when you start working young, because I started my first business when I was 23. And so you start working earlier and you spend more time working and you kind of get a bit of experience, a bit of, you know, you accrue some, you know, knowledge and yeah. So a number of things, but really it's the grace of God. I don't think that we're different from anybody else. It's just the grace of God. Yeah.
Actually, when I was listening to you, you actually did mention that You started your business at a very young age. That was at the age of 23. How did you manage to, get the finances? Did you have some money saved somewhere, or did you get a helping hand from other people? How did you get into, managing your own business at a very tender age?
No, the business was really, I had graduated and now I had to, find my way in the world. And so my parents encouraged me to start a business because they said, you need to learn how to be self-sufficient. So they didn't want me to work. I wanted to work in the UN. I thought that was the big deal. I thought that was the big thing that I could do. I thought that that's the way I could be, have impact. And they said, no, you start your own business. So when I started my own business, it was a company, a grain trading company. And it was very difficult. It was very challenging because I had no experience. I had no, really background in it. And I was very young. But what I really, the knowledge I gained out of it, the networks, it was a very great, launching into my life, adult life, but very challenging because when you start a business, when you're an entrepreneur, you never leave the office actually. You're always moving with all the issues of the business, whether it's employees, whether it's salaries, whether it's taxes, whether it's this, it never goes. You never say, oh, the boss will take care of it. You are the one who has to. So it's very challenging, but with hindsight, I really thank God. It was the best decision that I could have made because that has been my life now. I've never worked for anyone else or any other institution. And it has really helped me to know that you can actually build something, you can start something, and it can sustain you, and it can sustain many others. I remember my parents helped me with a land title. They said, we'll give you a land title and you can take a loan. And that was the loan that started the business. But from there, I paid the loan and continued.